Welcome back, Yembukeli. The time now is 28 minutes to 8, as we promised earlier that today we'll be looking into, a new territory, something we've never actually explored in this program, yoga. Here with me in the studio to tell us more about yoga, a practice that dates back to the second century, is the High Commissioner of India, Her Excellency, Randa Venta Raman, if I'm correct, and Mohini Nagindas, who is a yoga instructor. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Namaste. So that's how we greet, eh?
Yes.
And World Health Organization actually promotes that. Yes. We actually adopt such ways of greeting.
Yes. In days of COVID-19, doing this is much better than shaking hands with people.
Yes, it is. Okay, so on Sunday was a day where internationally yoga was celebrated.
Yes.
I think it was the fifth or sixth time.
Sixth international time. Day.
Yeah. So tell us more about how this day actually came about to be an internationally recognized day.
The Prime Minister of India, in a proposal to the United Nations General Assembly in September 2014, made a proposal that yoga should be made universal, and a day should be fixed on which International Day of Yoga should be celebrated all over the world.
Mm.
And the proposal of the Prime Minister of India got unanimous approval of the UN General Assembly, and 21st of June was declared as the International Day of Yoga.
Mm.
The 21st of June was chosen because it is the summer solstice day in the Northern Hemisphere, the longest day of the year, and it's a very auspicious day. So when the UN General Assembly declared 21st of June as International Day of Yoga, the celebrations were started from the year 2015. The first International Day of Yoga was held on 21st of June 2015. So 21st of June 2020 becomes the sixth International Day of Yoga.
Mm-hmm. Okay, but then maybe let's get to what really is yoga.
And before we answer that question, I just wanted to say that Mr. and Mrs. Ashraf have brought International Day of Yoga to Swaziland.
Mm.
So we have been doing that. The community has been doing that for many years, and that's how my interest had sparked for yoga.
Okay.
And that's now how I became a yoga instructor.
Mm.
You know, when you're watching and yoga coming to you, to your home, then you realize that this, you should be interested in this.
Mm.
And so you were asking, what is yoga? Yoga is actually, for me, it's almost a way of life. Where you can unite your body, your breath, and your mind. It sort of becomes in harmony, you know. And it's a form of an exercise, but it's very, it's more to do with your breathing technique.
Mm.
And with breathing, your mind is relaxed, your body is relaxed, and it's very beneficial for your health.
Mm. No. Your Excellency, I've heard that you also do yoga.
Yes, I do.
So how long have you been doing it, and how has it helped you?
I have been doing yoga for a very long time, though I have never been properly instructed by a yoga instructor.
Mm-hmm.
But there are some yoga asanas which can be done on a regular basis, which helps you. And one of the things which I have been doing and which has really benefited me is, as a young girl, I used to suffer from sinusitis, and much medication was done for me to cure me of sinusitis, but somehow it did not work. So I adopted yoga to find a solution for my problem, and that was breathing technique. As Mohini said, breathing is something very, very important for you, for a human being.
Mm.
The way we breathe helps us to become healthier.
Mm.
So one of the aspects of yogic practice is to learn how to breathe properly. So I learned one particular aspect of yoga, which is called pranayama, which is breathing exercise. There's a technique to it. So if you follow the technique and you do this yogic practice every day, I have been cured of my sinusitis.
Mm.
I do not get colds now. My colds are very, very mild. My chest congestion is completely gone because of this regular practice of pranayama, breathing exercise.
Mm-hmm.
So I continue to do it, and there are some few asanas which I continue to do which has benefited me.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so tell us about those different forms of yoga.
Yes, there are different forms. So, you know, in Swaziland, we do have people who do practice the different forms and who do teach the different forms. There are many, but a few in Swaziland is Ashtanga yoga and Vinyasa yoga.
Mm-hmm.
And I teach Hatha yoga. Hatha yoga is more to do with, it's almost every yoga pose you do or posture you do,
mm-hmm.
it's almost as if you're in a meditative state. So you're very calm and you're very collected.
Mm-hmm.
And as you're in the yoga pose, your breathing is very slow and you're almost meditating.
Mm. Okay, yeah.
So as you can see in the video right there, it's very important to do yoga with an instructor so they can tell you what you can and can't do.
Uh-huh.
Simple things, if you have back problem, there's certain yoga poses that would be harmful and could have an adverse effect. So maybe, you know, there's certain asanas or yoga poses that you could do while sitting on a chair with your back straight and instead of standing and doing as I'm doing in the video. And if you need more information on yoga, you could always WhatsApp me. I've shared my WhatsApp number. And I've created a yoga page on Instagram for beginners, people who are beginning yoga. And just the useful tips. And as you can see, why I'm saying it's so important to do it with a yoga instructor is that when you're bending your knee like that, most people, what they do is their knee goes over their toe. And in a way, you're really damaging your knee if you keep doing that over many years.
Okay.
So it is very important that you have a yoga instructor guiding you what is helpful for your body. And a simple yoga asana like this, where you are balancing, this is very good for balancing. And a lot of people put their foot on their knee. You can pop your knee out like that. So just the small variations you can do that, you know, not everyone can do certain yoga poses, but if you have someone guiding you and can do the yoga according to your body type and according to how you are flexible or not flexible, that's why it's very important to have someone who has a better knowledge and idea of yoga and more of as an instructor.
And how long does it take you to actually get into learning such skills and being able to balance yourself in such a way?
It has to do with discipline. You have to be disciplined. You can't say, oh, I'll do yoga today and I'll do it next year. It has to be every day. You know, and if you can't do yoga every day, even if it's once a week, but remember that everyone's body is different. For example, you could go to the gym and lift weights and maybe your friend could be lifting weights as well, but your body type is different. You know, same thing with yoga. There's certain yoga poses I could do that someone next to me could not do. But that's why you need to have yoga poses and do yoga that's applicable for your body type or for your strength, you know, your health issues as well. There's certain yoga poses when you do, like if you're twisting your body, for example, that helps with your internal organs, it helps with digestion. You know, if you have diabetes, it's good to do certain yoga poses so that your pancreas secrete just the right amount of insulin. And, you know, there's a whole science to this. And yoga is more of a holistic health than just an exercise. And that's why it's different to other disciplines, because it's more you're looking at it from a holistic way. And you're uniting your body, your mind, and your breath. So I can just tell you, for example, for you to take in a deep breath right now. Take in a deep breath. And do you see it's very important to breathe? Because if I didn't say breathe out, you would be there gasping for breath, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So that's why it's so important. And a lot of people forget when they're exercising, when they're doing yoga. That's why it's very important to breathe in and breathe out. And our an incorrect way of breathing is we breathe with, you know, we want to look fit. So we breathe with keeping our tummy in and tight. But that's a very incorrect way of breathing. When you're breathing, your tummy comes out. So when you're inhaling, your tummy comes out, it expands.
Okay.
And as you inhaling, it expands. And then your chest, that's where you get more oxygen from your chest and then from the top parts.
Mm-hmm.
As you're breathing out, you're releasing air from the top, from your chest. And then it's as if someone is pulling your belly button from your back. Your belly button goes all the way in as you're exhaling all the air out. So these common things that we take for granted, this thing has a huge effect on the way on our health. You know, the benefits of yoga, there's so many benefits: reduce stress, reduce anxiety, helping with reducing heart diseases. You know, just simple yoga asanas, the one that I had shared in the video, with building arm strength, upper body strength, lower body strength, how to sit correctly, you know, instead of slouching and sitting, you know, sitting upright, having this posture really helps with your shoulders, your neck. This can even help with office yoga as well. You know, when you're typing out or something, your hands are out, you know, instead of sitting like this at a computer. And this is what I share on my Instagram page as well. Just the correct ways of sitting and doing office yoga and office work.
I think let's talk about this pause, your excellency. Is this one of the things you actually do?
Yes, this is a breathing technique she's displaying to you. So as Mohini said, breathing is very important for your physical health. So the way you breathe is very, very important. So this is one technique which they are teaching you. Mohini can explain much better what exactly that is.
So basically in here, you're breathing from your stomach and you're exhaling the air out.
Okay.
So it's a quick breathe in and full exhalation, but not exhalation to the point where you breathe everything out, but just it's like, so it's like someone is pulling your belly button from the back. So it's just a simple breathing technique. There are many different breathing techniques, all that has different benefits. And we can go on and on about that.
Then in terms of bringing your thoughts together and actually coming down, does this technique actually help with that? You know, people are so stressed. Can this actually help you with just...
Yes, so there's different breathing techniques that can help with calming your mind. There's different breathing techniques that can help give you energy. You know, you could be in the office and you're really tired and you just need that 2-minute break. A yoga breathing technique can actually give you that energy because yet again, oxygen is going into your body and the right amount of oxygen. And also, you know, your energy levels increase after that. You feel more relaxed, you feel more calm, you feel more at peace. And then you can carry on and start your day again and start with your work again. So it's all these different, and even there's different yoga techniques that can just give you a burst of energy as well. Meditation also. Meditation doesn't have to be for 30 minutes long on, you know. It can even just be for 5 minutes.
Short.
You breathe, you close your eyes, and you just think of your next steps that you're going to do for the day. And then it's almost like a goal setting. There's different kinds of meditation.
So, Your Excellency, how do you plan to actually promote yoga? It seems like a very beautiful thing. It's so calming, you see. But how do you plan on promoting it locally so that even, you know, Eswatini get to get this experience?
Yes. As you know, the High Commission is new in Eswatini. And when I came to Eswatini, I came to know that there are a few yoga teachers here already, which includes Mohini. There are a few others who are practicing yoga here. So yoga is not completely unknown to your people. But in order for everyone to get to know it better, as part of the 6th International Day of Yoga celebrations, the High Commission of India has created a flash drive with various yoga information, which includes very clear instructions on video. COVID-19 has made us do this because I was planning before COVID really started, I was planning that I'll do an open air event in Eswatini, invite school children, because I personally feel yoga should be taught at a very young age for you to make it a part of your life. So if it is introduced to school children, it would be the most beneficial way of introducing yoga. So since COVID-19 intervened and I could not do an outdoor event, because yoga is something also done in nature. If you do it out in fresh air, it's much more beneficial to you. So I have created this flash drive and I have been distributing it to the cabinet members, the members of parliament, anyone interested in yoga, for them to learn something from it, and to stay in touch with the High Commission of India, who in turn will put them in touch with the local yoga teachers here in Eswatini. And if needed, we can bring in yoga instructors from India here, and I can have a regular yoga teacher in the High Commission if people show interest. That is possible. So we are here for you. The High Commission is here for you. Whatever information we can share, we will share with you. And we will organize regular events where people can come and participate with us and learn yoga.
But is it in terms of it being expensive, is it not expensive to...
No, definitely not. You know, right now we have online classes going on, so you just have to pay that subscription, you know. And so as long as you have Wi-Fi, I think then it would be beneficial. I've also started an Instagram page, you know, for people who are new to yoga. Just giving you, because what happens is that we see online, we see videos of everyone doing yoga. They're super flexible. They're doing everything. And you feel, I can't do that. So therefore, I've created a page where people who are still new to yoga can look at what I've created and put online and say, you know what, I can do this. And those are just simple yoga asanas that I have done and put online. And it's on the Yogi Mo on Instagram. And another thing that children can start yoga at a very young age, from about age 3. Yes, and so I'm a preschool teacher, and I have been teaching yoga at a preschool. And so I have seen that there are children who have benefited from that in a great deal. And, you know, they have better attention span, they're more calm and collected. And it also helps them emotionally, you know, and which we take for granted. And so, yeah, and so that's why, like, I feel with how yoga can be, you know, brought about to Eswatini is, you know, there are different practitioners, and I think it's important for you to see what would you like, which aspect of yoga would you like to focus on. For me, I prefer yoga like more in a meditative state, more slow, like hatha yoga is very, you easing into the yoga poses. As you can see, it's very slow, and you're focusing on your breath, you know. Each pose, this is done a bit faster in the video, but each pose is done with 2 to 3 breaths. And then you come out of that pose, and then you go into the next pose as well. So there's a lot of concentration, a lot of meditation that is done in the poses. And so, you know, as I have my Instagram handle on this page, and my number as well. So if anyone has any questions and stuff, and also I'll be working in the near future with Mr. Ashraf. We're planning on working on a project to bring yoga to Eswatini.
Okay. So, and then... you said people should start doing yoga from as early as 3, but then when is it now the time to call it quits, or should you do yoga until you die?
Yes, well, I think ma'am can even talk about this. Your father does do yoga.
Yes.
You know, so and there's really no age limit for yoga. As long as you have an instructor, a yoga instructor who knows who knows a lot about yoga and who can direct you and guide you. Because, you know, when you're young, you could do certain yoga poses. And as you get older, there's certain things that you find difficult. So maybe you would you would sit on a chair and do the yoga. Or
my dad is 90 years old now. And he's, touch wood, living a very healthy life. And he has been throughout his life doing one or other form of yoga. And even at 90, he's still in a physical condition to do it. So there is no age limit to, you know, upper age limit to doing yoga. It is as per your capacity. If you are able to do it, you do it. And I propagate introduction of yoga into at a very young age, because then it becomes a part of your life. It's like when you go to a gym when you are at teenager, or when you want to build up your biceps. But yoga is something which you can learn from childhood, and it becomes a part of your life. And when you grow up, then you are leading a healthier life because of practicing yoga. So as yoga is not just an exercise, it's not just building up your body. It builds up your mind too. That is the beauty of yoga. Yoga brings in, the word yoga in Sanskrit means union. And the union is between the body and the mind, and harmony with nature. So that is why yoga should be started at a very young age, and there is no upper age limit. It is, if you are able to do it, you continue to do it.
Okay, and then in terms of injuries,
mm-hmm.
you know, you did mention that every person needs to have an instructor,
mm-hmm.
you know. So how do you avoid getting injured while practicing yoga?
Yeah, so I think the most important is that when you do have a yoga instructor, I mean, a class could be, you know, 4, 5, or 10 people doing yoga at a time with an instructor. It's important to tell your instructor, these are my health issues, for example,
mm-hmm.
or if you might have sciatica or lower back pain, or you might have a neck issue or knee problems.
Knee injury.
Exactly. So whatever issues you do have, it's important to tell your yoga instructor. Then they can plan the class accordingly.
Mm-hmm.
And it's very important, if you don't have health issues, whenever you're doing yoga, any form of yoga, it's very important to go according to what your body tells you to do.
Mm-hmm.
And why yoga is so important is that when you listen with yoga, you begin to listen to your body.
Mm-hmm.
There's certain things, yes, you should push yourself to do.
Mm-hmm.
But there's certain times where you have to say, this is as far as my body can go right now.
Mm-hmm.
For example, when you're doing the yoga asana, bending forward,
mm-hmm.
what happens is, everyone has a misconception,
mm-hmm.
and this is what I explain on my page as well. Everyone has a misconception that when you're bending forward, you need to touch your toes.
Mm.
But what you're actually doing, you're bending from your lower back,
mm.
and you're stretching your lower back muscles.
Mm.
And not many people know this. And what happens is that your aim is touch your toes. So your whole back gets so curved and you really damage your back.
Mm.
So it's teaching you with an instructor that bending forward is bending your lower back and go as further as you can.
Mm-hmm.
If you can't touch your toes, that's
mm-hmm.
fine. But make sure that your back is straight. Your
mm-hmm.
upper back is straight.
Mm-hmm.
Your hamstrings are not pulling. If you feel this is as far as I can go, that's
mm-hmm.
okay. Because if you practice yoga every day, eventually you'll be able to get to that point.
Mm-hmm.
Flexibility increases when
yes.
you continue to do yoga.
Mm-hmm.
On a regular basis.
Yeah.
And that's the thing. Listen to your body. And that's why I think, as ma'am was saying, with the union, it's your body, breath, and mind.
Mm.
You're listening, you're becoming one, you're listening to your body.
Mm.
And as ma'am was saying as well, with nature, you begin to respect and understand nature. You know, you start taking care of nature.
Mm.
You appreciate the birds, the flowers, the greenery.
Mm.
You appreciate what you have. In Swaziland, we have beautiful scenery here.
Mm.
And doing yoga out in the open air, we have fresh air. We're so fortunate for that.
Mm.
And so being in harmony with nature, I don't think you can get anything better than that.
Mm. You guys are so passionate about yoga. Hey, we can talk the whole morning.
Yes, we can.
Any last words, Your Excellency, just words of encouragement to the viewers at home who might be interested in practicing yoga?
What I would like to say about yoga, many people have misconception that it is religious.
Mm.
Mm-hmm.
It is above all religion. Yoga is simply a union of body and mind.
Mm-hmm.
And body and mind, when it is together, you are in a better position to do better things.
Mm-hmm.
And when your body is flexible enough to listen to you, you are able to, it takes your command,
mm-hmm.
as Mohini said, to touch your toes.
Mm-hmm.
It's not necessary that you have to touch your toes, but if you bend your body in accordingly, as per your capacity, it brings you much more flexibility.
Mm.
So in the days of COVID-19 particularly, combating COVID-19 is a very important aspect for everyone in the world now. One of the ways of doing it is adopting yoga.
Mm.
By doing your breathing exercises, you are strengthening your lungs, and COVID is attacking your lungs.
Mm.
So learning breathing exercise is very important because it helps you to, you know your body as well as to strengthen your lungs. So particularly in these trying times for us, we feel that adopting yoga is very important. And that is why we said that we let us all come together and learn from each other and take yoga as an universal practice.
Mm.
And we are here for you to help you out in this matter.
Mm-hmm. Mohini, where can people find you, people who are interested in?
As I said, I had posted my Instagram handle. It's
mm-hmm.
At the Yogi Mo.
Mm-hmm.
And my number for WhatsApp to contact me, it's also in the video.
Mm-hmm.
And just if you have any questions, you can also ask Radha Ma'am and she'll direct you to me. And it's just basically, as Ma'am was saying, to work together to combat COVID-19. If you are looking at different online versions of yoga, please make sure that you have someone guiding you, someone who knows the knowledge of yoga, because the least you would want is to injure yourself, you know. And we want yoga to be seen as loving your body, loving yourself. This is the time where we take care of ourselves to, you know, you can't go out, so work within, as everyone has been saying.
Learning about your body and trying to be in harmony with nature.
Mm-hmm.
And as Mohini said, it has to be done with instructions only. In days of COVID-19, of course, the instructions are coming digitally.
Mm-hmm.
But it would be better for you to meet with a person who is a yoga instructor to learn first and then follow the videos.
I'll be coming for my lesson very soon. I think that's all the time we have this morning. Thank you very much for coming here.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
That was her Excellency Randa Venkata Raman, the High Commissioner of India, and Mohini Nagindas.
Yes.
I got it right. Yes. Who is a yoga instructor. They just told us more about yoga. You can just contact the High Commissioner and she will assist you with how you can go about joining or practicing yoga in the country. The time now is 2:08. We will now take a short commercial break, then come back and wrap up the show.